Music.com.
Now, was that, you know, book met, you know, from your family with any hesitation or reservation, you know, from you kind of putting out your family business, you know, kind of like airing out dirty laundry?
It took me 5 years to write the book. I didn't want it to be a book of putting out dirty laundry and that's it, you know, mm-hmm. a hate book. He did this and she did that.
Right.
I wanted the book to be of healing. So I asked God to, I wanted my heart to be right.
Right.
And so I began to deal with my heart in it. I love my mother. I love my father. So I didn't want it to be like, you know, look at daddy and he was this and he was this mean man and all that stuff. Not just that. I wanted it to be read as, look at a family. Look what Satan did, okay?
Uh-huh.
Look where it destined our life, you know? I felt as a child there was a call upon our lives and Satan saw that. And there's more demons, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When you have a call upon your life.
Right.
A gift. More the gifts than more the demons. And God gave us that gift. We knew that from a very early age. And when we backslid, he kept us.
Amen.
Kept us for this day. So it's not a book, a tell-all book of dirty laundry just to put it out there.
Right.
And look at this. No. But to in reality show how real Satan is and how Satan tried to destroy a family and how real God is.
Amen.
And how he's the only one that can deliver us.
Amen. Amen. Honor and Glory Radio, this is your boy G Wade. I have on the line with me Bunny DeBarge from the famous family, the DeBarge family. If y'all remember such projects, such songs like All This Love and Rhythm of the Night, really, really at the height of your career, their career in the mid 80s or something like that. And then, yeah, I guess at that point, did things just kind of turn around or, meaning in the sense of, go downhill, so to speak? Because that's kind of like when it started to tailor off for you guys.
Right. Our life started out, like I said, with abuse and we were very ashamed. My father being a white man, my mother being a black woman, and the things that happened to us in our childhood,
mm-hmm.
We were ashamed of the name DeBarge. We were ashamed of who we were. It was hard going to school. We were teased a lot, and we really didn't have anybody. My father's family just owned us, and
wow.
My mom's family, they loved us, but mm-hmm. there were times when they, you know how kids are, they can be cool, and they would
yeah.
say the cool things too. We just never felt apart. And all we had was our music. So when we did become famous, a lot of love came in, and we weren't used to that. And so we were there. We felt we took that name that we were ashamed of, and now we're proud of that name, you know. So it was a good thing for us, but we had all that hurt and that pain from our childhood. And here we are, being loved by people, our cousins, and everything like we wanted to be loved and fitting in, you know,
uh-huh.
but never really dealing with the pain that we went through. So we weren't able to sustain the success because
mm-hmm.
of that.
Yeah.
So then things, you know, happened. The group was broke up, not just the group, the family was broke up.
Mm-hmm.
And that pain there we never dealt with as a family. And kind of destroyed our relationship,
mm-hmm.
you know. Not so much the group that hurt; it was the family,
right?
You know?
Right.
Because we were a family that all we had was one another, and now we're just scattered apart and torn apart, and we have hurt one another now, and we're looking for one another and everybody else. We're putting everybody in our brothers and sisters' place because we would rather them hurt us than us hurting one another. That pain there, we just could not take.
Mm-hmm.
And just learning just how dysfunctional we are. We didn't even realize, you know, how dysfunctional we are. We were. And until I went back and viewed my life and wrote the book or whatever,
mm-hmm.
I started to see, you know, the things that I thought were right were wrong, you know.
Right.
Those were the things I really had to deal with. It wasn't so much the wrong things. It was the things that I really felt were right. And it was my season. I was ready for it, and God knew that. And he helped me to understand when I didn't understand. I mean, I didn't want to understand, you know, why things happen. And,
right.
And understanding that helped me to forgive, you know, when I saw who my enemy was,
mm-hmm.
you know,
mm-hmm.
and how my book was written before I was born, and that God knew that book. He knew everything that was going to happen to me, and that those things did not come to break me. They came to make me, and I went through them for a reason. I went through them not just for my children, but for your children, and, you know.
Amen.
The thing is, I got through, you know.
Right.
I got through. He allowed me to live and have my mind, and have the mind to want to go back and face those things with him.
Amen. And what I like is what you said in your bio, in an interview, you said God has turned your mess into your message. And that's what I want to talk about. We're going to take a break. In fact, we're going to jump into one of your songs. This is Trust in Jesus. We're going to jump into that. And when we get back, we want to find out what that message is and how can it help those who have and who are going through what you and your family have experienced. This is Honor and Glory Radio. I'm your boy, G. Wade. I have on the line Miss Bunny DeBarge. We'll be back right after this. Y'all keep it locked.